just like a lot of the old time commercial fishermen, like the fish houses, you know, especially the guys in Pine Island, they're strong and they're tough.
Hurricane Ian's wrath flattened homes across our barrier islands, but somehow these century-old houses, literally on the water, are still standing. The former fish houses stand on stilts in the middle of Pine Island Sound between Pine Island and Cayo Costa, where Hurricane Ian made landfall. They've been known by many names over the years, ice houses, the fish shacks, fish cabins.
All but one of these houses is still standing. NBC2's Gina Tomlinson is taking us out on the water, showing us the history of these landmarks.
Captain Brian Holloway, simply known by the locals as Captain Brian, has navigated these waters in Pine Island Sound for decades.
I've been a captain since probably coming up on 30 years.
He's seen and heard a lot.
There's Captiva, and we ran it right up here.
7 miles northwest of Captiva is a familiar sight with a lot of history.
And they're just on pilings and over the water.
Some built a century ago. These huts have stood the test of time.
Those fish houses tell a lot of stories.
Stories no one can tell you better than Jimmy Driggers.
I had a boat named the Mama June, and I had sold it going to retire.
Some good?
Yeah.
And about 4 years, I said, well, I'm too poor to retire. I got to go back to work.
Some bad.
Yeah.
Like losing his leg in an accident on the boat 20 years ago.
A shrimp boat.
Okay.
Driggers started at the Punta Gorda Fish Company at 13 years old.
I quit school out of the seventh grade.
Now?
86.
86?
Yeah.
Get out.
He's an elite company today, one of the few left who have worked in the fish houses in their prime.
Fishing people, they stayed there all the time. The Punta Gorda Fish Company, they had run boats. They would bring ice, gas, groceries, and down they'd leave on Monday, come down, and they'd go back the next day picking fish up.
With these shacks storing fish and ice, catches could be shipped nationally out of Southwest Florida for the first time in history.
They sent fish out by trainloads.
After World War II, the fishing industry boom came to an end. With bridges built connecting islands like Captiva, Sanibel, and Pine Island to the mainland, trucks started being used to transport fish, eliminating the need for runboats and the fish shacks.
Right there.
Many were sold off, destroyed, or left decaying in the water.
In the 1980s, the state decided the fish shacks were becoming a burden for wildlife and boaters. They would not exist today if it weren't for the group of people who took a stand to preserve them.
It's very fortunate that they got to be put on the National Registry of Historic Places.
A symbol of what the commercial fishing industry once was.
Our culture is going away, you know.
But these iconic fish houses, here for decades, weathered storms and hurricanes.
The one red one, it, even Charlie, give it a pretty good battle, but it stayed.
Over the years, some like this shack off of North Cap have been fixed up. When Hurricane Ian tore homes right out of the ground, like Driggers on Pine Island, many feared these fragile huts would be gone for good. Whether it's good old-fashioned craftsmanship or some kind of miracle.
I was very surprised and also very happy.
All but one of the shacks by Punta Blanca survived.
I think it's wonderful that they went through all of this stuff and still standing.
Just like a lot of the old-time commercial fishermen, like the fish houses, you know, especially the guys in Pine Island, they're strong and they're tough.
Pieces of the past prevailed. On the water in Pine Island Sound, I'm Gina Tomlinson, NBC2.